It's been over a year since the doors were shut at the House of Grace in Glens Falls due to a lack of funding. Previous executive director Rob Spratt allegedly stole more than $26,000 from the nonprofit organization over a nine-month period. Today, the home reopened their doors to the community and already has their first patient.
We ran out of money. We had to close. And then we hired a person to raise money for us as an outreach coordinator, and it turned out that he was embezzling the money. So we got hit double. So once we discovered all of that, it was climbing back out and being able to set a goal of getting this house reopened.
The House of Grace is a nonprofit organization that houses two residents that are terminally ill and gives them the comfort of home in their final stages of life.
There's no lack of need out there. There's a lot of folks that are in the final stages of life that would like to be in a home-like setting, and that's our mission, to have those folks come in and allow us to care for them and allow their families to be loved ones as opposed to caregivers.
Mark Griffin is the house's board president and told me that they set a goal at Christmas to make sure they welcomed patients back by April 1st. Today, the House of Grace achieved that goal.
It's big. It's very big, the fact that we were able to achieve that. And more importantly, as I said, we have a patient here. That patient needed us, and we were able to provide the help that she needed and for her family.
If you would like to donate or become a volunteer at the House of Grace, head to our website, looktvonline.com. We have a link. For Look News, I'm Megan MacDavid.